I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic. That's it. Very good. If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate.
Repair. Revelio. Repairer.
Nicely done. Works like a charm, doesn't it?
Well, fancy meeting you here.
Hello, Sebastian.
Ah, my new charge. I'm told you're in dire need of supplies, and I'm to accompany you into Hogsmeade for them. Is this your first foray into the village?
It is. I haven't left the castle since I arrived.
Well, I shall endeavor to be the very best of guides, then. Hogsmeade's a charming little place. Self-contained, too. We should be able to find you everything that you need. Shall we? I was glad Professor Weasley asked me to join you today.
As am I. Thank you, by the way.
Of course. You're the only one who's ever bested me in a duel. The way I see it, I'd be wise to keep an eye on you. Speaking of Weasley, she seems to have taken quite a shine to you.
Has she? That's nice to hear.
I'm still surprised that a professor would entrust me with anything, given my detention record.
Spend a lot of time in detention, do you?
Just enough to keep me well-rounded. Speaking of detention, this trip to Hogsmeade might have saved me from one.
Glad I could be of service.
Madam Scribner, the librarian, was on the hunt for me, as is often the case. Professor Weasley came to retrieve me, and I was able to convince old Scribner that I had somewhere to be.
So how did you manage to get on the librarian's bad side?
Well, I suspect it's a matter of differing opinions. She thinks I shouldn't be allowed in the restricted section, and I, on the other hand... Disagree. Oh, just one moment. This is an excellent spot to gather lacewing flies. They're pretty to look at. If you stew them long enough, they make a powerful potion ingredient. Merlin's beard from the Forbidden Forest. Look!
What's going on?
See for yourself. Quite a sight, isn't it? You certainly don't see that every day.
Do you think Poppy's already seen the hippogriffs?
Absolutely.
Likely already seen them.
Prancehoof and Sugarfoot.
Lumos.
To the left is the Forbidden Forest. Out of bounds.
Accio. Oh, hence the name.
Precisely.
Repel.
It's too dangerous. I think they need to have more confidence in our defensive abilities. Ah, you can see Hogsmeade just past those ruins up ahead. Have you had much of a chance to explore the castle?
A little. It's positively enormous.
It is that. I've been there 5 years and barely scratched the surface. Loads to see. Places to discover.
Oh? Any you'd like to share with the class?
Perhaps one day. I can't go around telling you all my secrets now, can I? You still haven't told me how you became so good at dueling.
I've always thought Thestrals pulling a carriage a bit grim. Though I suppose most people don't actually see them at all.
But you can see them.
Unfortunately. But you've seen quite a bit yourself firsthand too. Most notably that dragon attack. Hopefully the rest of your year isn't as eventful.
Mr. Moon! He's the Hogwarts caretaker. Looks a bit worse for wear. Hello, Mr. Moon. Have you met our new fifth year?
Pleasure. You might want to turn back, Mr. Sallow. Turn and run.
Is everything all right, sir?
Oh, look right at me. Eyes big as saucers.
What did, Mr. Moon?
Demi guys. Ugly and airy and terrifying. I shall be at the castle where it's safe. Good luck to both of you.
A demi, guys. I don't know what he's putting in his pumpkin juice, but he's obviously had too much of it. I've never seen Mr. Moon in such a state.
Mr. Moon is quite the character. My sister Anne thinks he's lovely, but I'd say he could improve a bit as a caretaker.
Oh, is your sister in Slytherin too?
She is, or rather, she was. She's not well at the moment, but she'll be better soon and back at Hogwarts. Honestly, if one could bottle the magic of this place... I don't know if it's the shops or the people, but there's just something about Hogsmeade. We all flock to it like moths to a flame. So how would you like to do this? Weasley told me you had a list of things to get, a wand and some other bits.
Yes. Dittany seeds, some spellcrafts, and some potion recipes.
Perfect. Can't wait to see what you do with the new wand. And a short list gives you plenty of time to poke around the village. I just have to pop into a shop to find something for my sister. Let's meet up in the town circle when you're finished. Remember, have fun. It's Hogsmeade.
I'll be right with... Ah, it's you. Just a moment, please.
Hello, sir. I'm looking for...
For a new wand, yes. It's about time.
Yes, about time?
Well, you're our new fifth-year student, are you not? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you are. Gerbold Ollivander's the name. But of course, you'll have heard of the Ollivanders, I'm sure. Finest wand makers in the world. It's a pleasure to meet you, truly. Now, come with me. Let's find you the perfect wand, shall we? No, not you. Yes. Powerful core. 10.5 inches. You might do. Here, give this one a try. Well, go ahead, swish. How odd. Once more, come on, really swish it. Oh, dear. Well, this isn't a good match at all, is it? We'll find you something, not to worry. No, not you. Perhaps... Yes. A rare wood, 13¾ inches, dragon heart string. Let's give this one a try. Goodness! Looks like it's back to the shelf for you. This is proving to be trickier than I had anticipated. How perplexing. Where are you? Perhaps you? There you are. Yes. I think you might be the one. Here, take it. How intriguing.
Curious indeed.
How intriguing.
Curious indeed.
Intriguing.
Curious indeed.
How intriguing.
Thank you. Curious indeed.
How intriguing.
Another wand, another beginning of a bright and magical future.
Now, how did that feel?
Good. Different. I sensed a sort of surge of some kind.
A match. Your connection seemed particularly powerful. The right wand will learn from you, just as you learn from it.
I'm eager to try it out.
I would imagine so. A wand with a dragon heartstring core is capable of dazzling magic. And the bond between you and your wand should only grow stronger. Do not be surprised at your new wand's ability to perceive your intentions, particularly in a moment of need.
That sounds wonderful, Mr. Ollivander.
I'll let you get to it. Do come and see me again if ever I can be of further assistance.
Told you not to go down that path.
Miss Peck from Boozing Pets said a customer lost a Deerical around here. I know we're not supposed to.
Welcome to J. Pippin's Potions.
Pardon me, sir.
Oh, thank goodness. When I heard the bell, I thought you were Miss Lawang. Not that she deigns to come here. Though, I don't believe I've seen your face here before, either.
It's my first time in Hogsmeade, actually.
Is it really? Well, Parry Pippin at your service. And this is J. Pippin's Potions. Potions for all ailments. You'll have read it on the sign, of course, but Grandfather always made me say it in full. How may I help you today?
Professor Weasley sent me to collect some recipes. I'm new at Hogwarts.
You're the student she sent the owl about. I set your things aside immediately. I suspected if you're anything like I was at your age, you'd want your potion supplies. Is it not the most fascinating art, potion making? Rivals anything you can do with a wand, I've always said.
Are potions really that versatile?
They may not be as showy as spellwork, but make no mistake, they are just as powerful. They can heal, destroy, protect. You'll discover all of this soon enough. As it's your first time in, I should mention that it's not just potion recipes I sell. I also offer ready-made drafts for all manner of uses, and I unveil new ones from time to time. Pop in when you can so you don't miss out on anything. But for now, let's get you those recipes, shall we? What can I do for you today? Free to take a look at the rest of my inventory, or come back another time if you're in a rush today. What can I do for you today?
Rebellion. Revelio. Revelio. Repairer. Lumos.
An inquiring mind.
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the spellcrafts Professor Weasley ordered.
Matilda, student. I thought I might be seeing you soon. I am the proprietor here, Thomas Brown. I take it you've had a conjuring lesson, then?
I'm afraid I haven't yet, sir.
Ah, but you will soon enough. It is magic at its purest, creating something out of nothing. Of course, it is not without complexity, but that is where my spellcrafts come in. Stay the course, and you could soon impress even Professor Weasley.
That's certainly something to aspire to, Mr. Brown. I look forward to that day.
And I, too, see in it. Spellcrafts are incredibly useful for conjuring unique items like custom pieces of furniture or decoration. But I shall let Professor Weasley do the teaching. For now, let's get the spellcrafts you need. A potting table and a potion station. Yes?
I believe so, sir.
Good.
Good. Nothing like being able to grow your own ingredients and brew what you want, when you want. Let's have a look. Let's look at what we have, shall we? If you're interested, feel free to take a look around at the rest of my inventory.
Revelio.
Well, hello there.
Revelio. Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the seeds Professor Weasley arranged for me to collect.
Ah, the Dittany for the new fifth year. I take it that's you, then. Merlin's beard. Starting Hogwarts as a fifth year. You must be positively reeling from it all.
Not at all. I'm choosing to see it all as one big adventure.
Well, bravo. Not everyone has the temperament to take things as they come. Name's Timothy Teasdale, by the way, and this is my shop, the Magic Neep. I keep the cart out here because I like a good chat. Can't very well be in the thick of things if I'm hidden away inside now, can I?
I suppose not.
In addition to seeds, I have plenty of plants. Grow everything myself. My speciality is potion ingredients. Even Pippin purchases from me. But what say we get you a packet of Dittany seeds?
Let me guess. You're after something fresh.
Do have a look around. Plenty of ingredients to pique your interest, I'd wager.
Well, that's everything. Better go and find Sebastian.
Action!
Hello.
Oh, come in, come in. Welcome to Madame Snelling's Tress Emporium. I'm sure I've no need to introduce myself. They used to call me Snelly. Oh, Snelly, why aren't you studying to be an Aura? But I showed them. They're stuck in the dust at the Ministry and I'm here thriving. Absolutely thriving. But look at you. Look at you. I can certainly see why you paid me a visit. Looking for a change, are we?
I'm not sure what you mean, but I'm quite all right as I am.
Some are going for that muggle with consumption sort of death becomes me allure. But you won't find poisons here. No need for chloride of lime or ammonia when you have magic. Why don't you spend a moment choosing how you'd like to look? You can change your hair too if you'd like.
What services do you offer?
What is it you might be interested in? What is it you might be interested in?
I officially have all of my supplies.
Excellent.
Did you get what you needed for your sister?
I did. So I suppose the world is our oyster now. Let's see what else we can get up to.
goodness! A second troll! Did you two take on a fully grown troll by yourselves?
I suppose so. It's all a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Merlin's beard. Are you all right?
We are, and we were glad to help.
I'd say help is a bit of an understatement. Nerve like that. The makings of an aura, if you ask me. If you are unharmed, perhaps the two of you wouldn't mind helping me put a few things back to where they were.
Of course, Officer.
Singer. Officer Singer. And thank you, again.
Oh, hello there. A moment, if you would.
I'll go and see what he wants.
Repair.
Repair. Last thing for Officer Singer to worry about.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Repairer! Repair.
Mr. Hill was just singing your praises.
Hello, sir. I don't believe we've met.
Allow me to introduce myself. Augustus Hill, clothier extraordinaire. I should like to thank you for your remarkable bravery in fighting those trolls, and not to mention your help restoring Hogsmeade to its rightful state.
I was happy to help.
Frankly, you deserve an Order of Merlin. But I can offer you something much more useful. I own Gladrag's Wizardware, and among my inventory are some unique items that afford certain protections, as it were. Life-saving protections. And as I suspect this won't be your last dangerous encounter, I'd like to give you one such set of robes, in thanks for what you did today.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Hill. That's very generous of you.
It's the least I can do. Now, let's try this on for size, shall we? Plenty for your perusal today. Take your time.
I'd say we've earned a butterbeer or two, wouldn't you? Might help me forget that I was almost pulverized by a troll.
I'd say that I agree with you.
Perfect. The three broomsticks is just this way.
I sell even more battle-worthy items, should you be inclined. Most welcome to peruse my shop at your leisure. Plenty for your perusal today. Take your time. Plenty for your perusal today. Take your time.
Assuming it isn't utter bedlam in there, you might even meet Serona, the owner. She's a good one to know.
You said you could get to the child when they came to Hogsmeade. That all you needed was a distraction. I gave you a distraction.
I just watched a student take down your distraction. Who's this child? What are you not telling me?
All you need to know is that if you cannot get to the child, then you have no value to me.
Let's go.
Did they see us?
I don't think so.
What was that goblin doing with Victor Rookwood?
Ranrock is working with Rookwood.
The goblin from the Daily Prophet. I knew I'd seen him somewhere. Quickly, let's get inside the Three Broomsticks.
It's a treat to see you, Lord Gok. I shall let you know if I hear anything.
Thank you, Serona.
You be well. Now, what can I... Oh, there's a face I haven't seen before.
It's my first time here.
Welcome. Butterbeer's on me. Heard about the attack. I shall be looking in on the other shopkeepers and residents shortly. Glad to see you two escaped injury.
Thanks to this one. Single-handedly took down a troll.
Is that right? Well done.
Thanks for this.
My pleasure. I will say, trolls in Hogsmeade. That's never happened before. Something's not right. The only brutes we usually have to deal with are... How timely.
Was that Lodgok I saw leaving just now? Your clientele's not what it used to be, Serona.
Not to worry, Victor. Once the two of you leave, the caliber of my clientele will greatly improve. I wouldn't do that if I were you, Theophilus.
Come now. No need for theatrics. I'm only here for this one anyway.
My friend is enjoying a well-earned butterbeer.
Only want a quick word.
Perhaps you didn't hear me. I said, my friend is busy.
One would think you all had enough bloodshed for one day. Come, Theophilus. The Three Broomsticks isn't what it used to be. Let's take our galleons elsewhere. Can't drink butterbeer forever.
Seems you've made an unfortunate enemy. Watch your back. Rookwood and Harlow are worse than any troll you might encounter.
Trolls? Ranrock and Rookwood? What are you not telling me?
I promised to tell you everything, but it's perhaps best I do that later.
And on that note, I think we should head back to the castle. Revelio.
I'm certainly glad Serona was there. Told you she was one of the good ones.
I can see that. She didn't seem at all intimidated by Rookwood and Arlo.
I think you'll need to tell me why Victor Rookwood has you in his sights. But we can talk later. For the moment, we should return to the castle. Professor Weasley's certain to hear about the troll attack soon if she hasn't already. Don't want to risk another detention for getting back after hours.
Revelio.
drinkers in this next piece.
Revelio. Accio. Reparo. Levioso.
What do you want? That life is behind me. Away from me.
My, what a striking face. You'll make quite the portrait. I wouldn't want to be hung next to you.
Lumos. Revelio.
When they ask you a question now, isn't it? Grubby little faces. I'll just die. If someone gets...
Revelio. Lumos.
House ghosts can procure rancid meat and no one says a word. One man.
Revelio. Lumos.
Stepping, they'll only think it's me. Don't think it's the delightful something. Has one person even tried to sort this?
Revelio.
No.
Revelio. Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Revelio.
What do you think Black Wife is like?
Revelio.
I've always said that travel
Revelio.
Is the mind.
Lumos. Revelio. Revelio.
Professor, I'm glad to see you.
And I you. Thank Merlin you're in one piece. I heard about the attack. Trolls in Hogsmeade?
Sir, the trolls were wearing armor. It had that dark glow like the dragon collar.
Goblin silver! Ranrok used it to control the dragon. But how? And why send trolls to...
They were there because of me. I overheard Ranrok talking with Victor Rookwood.
Ranrok was in Hogsmeade? With Rookwood?
The trolls were Ranrok's distraction so that Rookwood could get to me. And he would have, had Serona and the patrons at the Three Broomsticks not intervened.
This is grave news indeed. If Ranrok's goblins and dark wizards are after you, they want what we found in that vault.
Speaking of the vault, do you think that Ranrok is working with any of the goblins at Gringotts?
I do not. Gringotts goblins aren't typically the friendliest of beings, but they have a great deal of integrity. No, I dare say after what happened to that poor banker, the goblins at Gringotts are no followers of Ranrok.
They're after the locket. You said you discovered something in it.
Yes, yes. I discovered an inscription. When I read it aloud, this map appeared. Clever enchantment. It's a map of Hogwarts, to be sure, but I do not know where it leads.
It leads to the library. A restricted section, to be precise, and a bit beyond. I see traces of magic there on the map.
I suspected you would see something.
Shall we go?
I appreciate your enthusiasm, and I'm eager to discover what we may find there as well. But if our experience at Gringotts, let alone what happened to Miriam, taught me anything, it's that the path we're on is terribly dangerous. I'd like you to work with Professor Hecate a bit, before we continue.
But sir, how dangerous could the library be? Perhaps we're only after a book.
Perhaps we are only after a book, but we should be prepared for anything. Once you've honed your defensive magic further, come and see me. I'll let Professor Hecate know to expect you.
I don't think I can do this now. Best to come back. I don't think I'm ready for this just yet.
Revelio!
Perhaps I'll come back to this. I don't think I can do this now. Best to come back.
Revelio.
Thank you.
Revelio.
Ah, I believe we have...
I'm here about the new spell you wanted to teach me, Professor.
Good. Professor Fig indicated a certain urgency to you completing your defensive magic assignments. As such, you are to learn Incendio, the fire-making spell, handy for lighting torches, burning away spider webs, and, when necessary, defending against those who would wish to do us harm.
Sounds versatile.
Quite. But before we get started, I'd like you to complete a few tasks. You may be surprised by some of them. Astonishing how much students don't think their professors know. When you're finished, come and see me. Then we shall begin working on Incendio. You know where to find me once you've finished.
Seems Crossed Wands isn't as secret as it's believed to be. Professor, could you remind me what I'm to do before I can learn Incendio?
Certainly. Complete the list of tasks I provided. Then come and see me. At that point, I will teach you the fire-making spell.
Revelio.
Ready for another round?
I think so. We shall see who shows up.
There's no one in the school I'd be afraid to duel.
I know, Sebastian. I know.
Hello, Lucan. Is the next round of Crossed Wands all set?
Why, yes it is. I've got a great match lined up. Ready for another round?
I'm ready. Let's do it.
Brilliant. Are you dueling with a partner?
Yes, Sebastian.
Then let's get to it.
Ready to get thrashed?
Apologies in advance.
Let's go!
I gave it my all.
You did indeed. The other duelists have already taken notice of you, but after that last round, they'll really have it in for you. You'd better keep practicing if you want a chance at winning, or at least surviving the next round. I'll let you know when we're ready. Hope to see you then. The next round is for all the gobstones, so to speak. You could have gone a bit easier on me.
Seems I'm out of the tournament, thanks to you.
Perhaps I should stick to potions.
Hello, Lucan. May I use the training dummy?
Of course. I'll fetch it and give you a list of combinations to practice. Ready to have a try now?
That would be wonderful.
Be sure to cast all your spells before the dummy lands. If you need to stop practicing before you finish all of them, let me know. You looked good out there.
Thank you, Lucan.
I say better to discover one's weaknesses during practice than during a duel. You'll be a fearsome challenger now.
Assignment's all finished.
I trust Mr. Brattleby was able to...
I finished all of the tasks you gave me, Professor Hecate.
Glad to hear it. Then you should be ready to learn Incendio.
Should be, Professor.
Yes. I'm sorry to say, I visited enough careless colleagues at St. Mungo's to assure you that fire is a fickle servant. Your spellcasting has impressed me thus far, but please maintain focus. I would rather we not end today's lesson with your robes aflame. Let us begin. And remember, focus on the proper wand movement. Concentrate, and keep your wand steady. Good work.
Incendio.
Getting it. Keep at it. And do try not to incinerate yourself. Spare a moment. I could use your help.
You wanted to speak with me?
I did. Hello, I'm Duncan Hobhouse. Pleasure to meet you. I've heard all about you, of course, confronting trolls and dragons.
That's nice to hear. I have had my share of adventure. I hope my reputation's warranted.
I'm going to presume your reputation is, in fact, warranted. In which case, you are precisely the person I need. You see, we were learning to repel boggarts in Professor Hecate's class, and, well, mine unfortunately took the shape of a puffskein.
Surely you're joking. You can't possibly be afraid of a puffskein.
It may seem irrational to you, but my experience with them has been most upsetting. They eat bogies, you know. Regardless of how reasonable I believe my fear of puffskeins to be, I'm beginning to get a reputation as a coward. Some have even taken to calling me Puffskein Dunkeen.
I'm sorry, but you have to admit that's rather clever.
I do not have to admit that. Everett said the same thing. Anyway, to make matters worse, I stupidly blurted out that I must be braver than people think, since I have been in the Hidden Herbology Corridor.
The Hidden Herbology Corridor?
Yes. Rumor has it that the herbology professor before Professor Garlic kept dangerous plants there. It's supposedly so overrun now that no one dares enter it anymore. I was hoping you could go there and bring back evidence that I could use to show that, well, I'd gone in. Say a bit of an exceptionally dangerous plant of some kind.
What sort of plants should I expect in the Hidden Herbology Corridor?
I haven't a clue. But have you seen the kinds of plants Professor Garlic grows? If the previous professor was anything like her, I'd imagine they're not exactly harmless.
Very well. If I'm in the area, perhaps I shall take a look.
Grand. I'd very much appreciate it. Come and find me if you get the proof. I shall be forever in your debt.
Hidden Herbology Corridor. Sounds intriguing.
Mm-hmm.
Revelio. Incendio!
These dry vines are one spark away from becoming kin. This must be the entrance to the hidden herbology corridor.
Revelio.
Devil's snare. Seems to thrive in darkness. Perhaps it doesn't care for light.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Lumos.
Seems the Devil's Snare was protecting a chest of some kind.
Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Incendio. Incendio. Lumos.
I imagine a piece of that enormous venomous tentacular would be enough for Duncan to prove his bravery.
Incendio.
Lumos.
Incendio. Lumos. Incendio. Protego. Lumos. Revelio.
Lumos.
I can think of that.
Have you found anything to, prove my...
Hello, Duncan. I have the proof you wanted.
That's one leaf. Must have been a giant venomous tentacular. It's even more than I expected. I knew you were the one to ask. I appreciate you getting it for me.
Now that I think about it, Puffskeen Dunkeen, I think I shall keep this. You need to overcome your cowardice.
You can't be serious. This is awful. I don't know what to do now.
I'm doing you a favor. Disappointment like this will encourage you to become a stronger person.
I don't need to be stronger. I need to be left alone. Even Zenobia Noak will make fun of me now. You've wasted my time. You're not who I thought you were. Should never have trusted you.